rate of reaction or rate constant. So in the previous class we finished two important topics. What we have finished in the previous class was, first thing, it was pseudo first order reaction. We have finished pseudo first order reaction. So do you remember what is pseudo first order reaction? So it is actually bimolecular reaction, means two molecules will be there, in which concentration of one of the reactivity is very high as compared to the other. Then the rate of reaction depends on the concentration of reactant which is in low concentration. That is called a pseudo first order reaction. Then second one, what we have studied is effect of temperature on rate constant. Effect of temperature on rate of reaction or rate constant. So as per Arrhenius theory, what Arrhenius has said, for every 10 degree Celsius increase in temperature, if you increase temperature by 10 Celsius, the rate constant is doubled. Then he has given so many equations, lot of equations, that is K is equal to A into e power minus Ea by RT, then log K. Log K is equal to log A minus Ea by RT, 2.303 RT, then log K2 by K1. When temperature is changed, the rate constant is also changed. That is Ea by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. Yes. These all things are studied in the previous class. We have finished all these. Now what we have to learn today? We have also learned the reason behind it. So what was the reason behind it? So if you take any reaction container, the fraction of molecules is given as Ne by Nt, and then here kinetic energy. So there will be less number of molecule with less energy, and there will be less number of molecule with more energy. We have drawn these all things. So this is the graph at temperature T. Now this is the activation energy. So the molecules which have the energy more than weight, they only involve in reaction. As the temperature is increased by 10 Kelvin, the graph flattens. So this is the graph at T plus 10 Kelvin. So now the extra molecules, these many extra molecules are coming, whose energy is more than activation energy. These are the previous class we discussed. So this is a revision of our previous class. Now today what are we going to discuss? Only two things are left in our chapter. One is effect of catalyst and another one is collision theory. Okay, so let us try to finish those two. Once if those two topics are over, then chapter is over. Fine. So let us see here, effect of catalyst. Effect of catalyst on rate of reaction. Rate of reaction. Yes. What is the meaning of catalyst? We have already studied about this in lower classes. 10th, 11th, every time we have seen. Catalyst means. Catalyst means any substance which increases, but it is not necessary to increase. There are some catalysts which decrease also.
So the catalyst which alters, I can say, which alters means either increase or decrease the rate of reaction without taking part in reaction. Yes, and that substance is called as catalyst substance which increase or decrease the rate of reaction without taking part in reaction. So example, we have very very famous example, potassium chlorate, KClO3, potassium chlorate. When you heat, it gives KCl, potassium chloride plus oxygen gas. We get this. For 1 mole of KClO3, it needs around 24 hours time. It needs almost 24 hours time. But if you add a small amount of manganese dioxide, then the whole reaction will complete in half an hour. You see, before adding manganese dioxide, the reaction was completing in one day, 24 hours. But now, when you add small amount of manganese dioxide, the whole reaction gets complete in half an hour. It means here MnO2 is increasing the rate of reaction, which means it is acting as catalyst. Right. So now, what is the reason behind it? So, how the rate of reaction is increased? So we should learn the reason behind the rate of reaction. I mean, reason behind the role of catalyst. For that, we need to recall Arrhenius theory. According to Arrhenius equation, as per Arrhenius equation, K is equal to A into e power minus Ea by RT. Is it right? Now, what is the relation between K and Ea? Rate constant and activation energy, what is the relation? Here, rate constant K is inversely proportional to activation, because minus sign is there. So keep this in mind. So this is the relation between rate constant and activation energy. Now, let us see the normal way of proceeding of reaction. This is energy, and here reaction coordinate means time. Reaction coordinate means time, and here energy. Normally this is the energy of reactant. Reactants collide to form an activation complex, and the activation complex gets decomposed and we get products. This is the normal path of reaction. What is this value? This value is called as, what can you call this one? This is called activation energy. So it's the amount of energy needed to form activation complex. Now, when catalyst is used, the catalyst diverts the path of reaction. Catalyst, what will do? It will divert the path of the reaction and decreases the activation energy. So catalyst will change the path of reaction. Beginning and ending will remain same, but the path is changed. Now you see what is the catalyst here. I mean activation energy, that is the Ea dash. Here this blue color one graph is with catalyst. Blue color graph is with catalyst, and the red color one is without catalyst. So on adding catalyst, what happens to activation energy decreased means the rate of reaction increases. That's the answer. So if somebody asks you the reason why the catalyst increased the rate of reaction, so reason what will you? The catalyst catalyst lowers the activation energy of reaction and increases the rate of reaction as per Arrhenius theory. So catalyst, see, two things we have to keep in mind. When catalyst is used, activation energy decreases, and when temperature increases, in the previous case, when temperature increases, activation energy does not change yet. So this is the reason behind this. Now the limitations of catalyst, or I can see the characteristics of catalyst. What are the characteristics? Two things are there. First one, it has no effect, or it means catalyst, it has no effect on equilibrium state. It has no effect on equilibrium stage of reaction. Means when you increase the reaction, when you add catalyst, if the reaction is in equilibrium state, it will not be changed. Why? You know, we have said in the 11th class also, if you add something catalyst here, catalyst will speed up the forward reaction as well as backward reaction. So it means the speed of both forward and backward are increased. It means the reaction again remains at equilibrium state. That's why it has no effect on equilibrium state. Similarly, it does not change del H, enthalpy of reaction. Enthalpy of reaction means what? Enthalpy of reaction is enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactant. Is it correct? So in the graph, this is the enthalpy of reactants and this is the enthalpy of products. So this value is del H, and that value remains same before catalyst and after catalyst. The value of del H remains same, it is not changing. This is the del H value, it remains constant. So it means catalyst does not change del H value. If del H does not change, then del G does not change. Del G means Gibbs energy. Gibbs energy depends on del H. So del H is not changing, so del G does not change. If del G does not change, then equilibrium constant K. This is the rate constant, this is the equilibrium constant. Equilibrium constant Kc, so does not change. So it means catalyst has no role on del H, del G and equilibrium constant Kc. These are the two important characteristics of catalyst. Understood catalyst here? So see what we have discussed. So catalyst means any substance which alter means increase or decrease the rate of reaction without taking part in reaction. Without taking part means at the end of the reaction we will get again MnO2. So it means indirectly we involve, but at the end we get the same product, same compound. So how, what is the reason behind it? So reason is we need to remember Arrhenius theory. Arrhenius theory says that rate constant is inversely proportional to activation energy. When catalyst is used, the path of reaction is diverted. Remember, you have right here, the catalyst lowers the activation energy of reaction by diverting the path of reaction. Here the path of reaction is changed. So activation energy is now decreased. Activation energy decreased means rate of reaction is increases. So del H is equal, rate of reaction increases. So here catalyst has no effect on equilibrium stage and it does not change del H. Change in enthalpy, del G or equilibrium constant, everything. So this is all about catalyst concept. Then understood? Take the notes. Fine. So effect of temperature over and effect of catalyst also over. If you can rewind the video, I told you in the beginning, factor affecting rate of reaction. There I said effect of temperature and effect of catalyst will come at the end.
Yes.
Effect of temperature also over and effect of catalyst also over. Now the last one is collision theory. Yes. Next topic it is collision theory. Yes. What is the meaning of collision theory? What is its role? So let us see. The collision theory has one important assumption. So it has very very important assumption. This theory has assumed the reactants as hard spheres. This theory said reactants are hard spheres and they collide with each other and result in the formation of products and results in the formation of products. This is collision theory statement assumption. So they said each reactant is a hard sphere like a ball. So and they collide with each other and results in the formation of products. So consider a reaction that is A plus B gives some products. A and B are reactants. What we are assuming is A and B are hard spheres, so they collide with each other and result in the formation of products. So according to Arrhenius theory, the rate of reaction is given as rate of reaction is equal to ZAB into e power minus EA by RT. This is the Arrhenius equation. Here we will see what is ZAB, where ZAB is called as collision frequency. ZAB is called collision frequency. Collision frequency means the number of collision between A and B per unit time and unit volume. So ZAB indicates what? How many collisions are occurring between A and B per unit time. So what is a collision frequency? Means number of collisions between A and B per unit time and unit volume. And e power minus EA by RT. E power minus EA by RT will tell. Here ZAB is telling what? How many collisions are occurring between A and B? Out of those collisions, how many collisions have energy more than activation energy? Because we have studied a very important condition. If the energy of reactant is more than activation energy, then only protein will form, otherwise protein will not form. So here these many collisions are occurring, let us say 20 collisions. Out of these many collisions, how many collisions have energy more than activation energy? That number we will get here. So e power minus Ea by RT indicates the number of molecules whose energy is more than activation energy. So how many number of molecules are there whose energy is more than activation energy, that we will get here. So this is about the second term. So ultimately what are we studied so far is these many collisions occur between A and B, and out of these collisions only these many molecules have energy more than activation energy, they only result in the formation of products. मतलब अगर आपको सिंपल समझाऊं तो इतने कोलिजन्स हो रहे हैं और उस कोलिजन्स में इतने कोलिजन्स के पास एनर्जी एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी ज्यादा है. जैसे स्टूडेंट 100 स्टूडेंट्स एग्जाम ले रहे हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल 12th क्लास में 100 स्टूडेंट्स एग्जाम में आया है, क्या 100 में से 100 स्टूडेंट्स को एडमिशन मिलेंगे इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज में? नहीं. पहले तो कंडीशन है कि 12th पास होना चाहिए. Let us say इतने students 12th pass हो, let us say 80 students 12th pass हो, ये 80 students है 12th pass हो. अब 12th में भी जिसका percentage 90 करोड़ है उन्हीं को admission मिलेगा. तो it means ये जो number है हमें बताएगा भाई इतने students है जो 80 students है उनमें कितने के पास 90% के ऊपर marks है. अब समझ में आया example? तो हमें 12th के बाद engineering college में admission है, बट डायरेक्टली एडमिशन नहीं मिले इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज में, सेटिंग कभी नहीं मिले. कंडीशन है दो कंडीशन, क्या कंडीशन है? एक तो ट्वेल्थ पास होना चाहिए, लेट अस से ट्वेल्थ पास होने वाला स्टूडेंट 80 स्टूडेंट है मान लेते हैं 80, और 80 में कितने के पास 90% के अबाउट है तो ये बताएगा. इट मीन्स ये दोनों जरूरी है. बट अब ये कोलिजन्स में सिर्फ एनर्जी वाला एक फैक्टर ही कंडीशन इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, एक और पॉइंट आता है दैट इज इफेक्टिव कोलिजन्स और फ्रूटफुल कोलिजन्स. इफेक्टिव कोलिजन्स और फ्रूटफुल कोलिजन्स, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस? इट मींस सपोज 100 मॉलिक्यूल्स आर कोलाइडिंग, all the molecules with all the collisions will not give products. Previously what we have studied, what we assumed is the reactants collide and result in the formation of products. But now what we understood is all the collisions will not give products. So only some collisions which result in the formation of products which are called as effective collisions. So definition, the collisions among reactants which results in the formation of products, which results in the formation of products are called as effective collisions. Fine, understood? Now, what collisions are effective? What are the conditions for those effective collisions? Conditions, there are two important conditions. Point number one, the energy of colliding molecules must be more than activation energy, otherwise product will not form. So the energy of colliding molecule should be more than activation energy, point number one. Point number two, colliding reactants must collide in reactants must collide in proper direction or orientation. It means they should collide in a specified direction. Example, if I take H2 and I2, if they collide in this direction, this is the H2 molecule, this is the I2 molecule. If they collide in this direction, then only H-H bond will be broken, H-I bond will be formed, I-I bond will be broken, and H-I bond will be formed. And later on, they get H-I and two molecules of H-I later on. But if they collide in this direction, H2 and I2, if they collide in this direction, you see, this is the H2 molecule, this is the I2 molecule. So even though energy is more than activation energy, it will not result in any products. Here, no products will be formed. It means two conditions are necessary. Condition number one, energy of colliding molecules should be more than activation energy. Condition number two, reactants must collide in proper direction or orientation. H2 should collide H2 negative in this way. This is not a proper direction. Here, no product will be formed. Now here, we said that ZAB means how many collisions are occurring and how many molecule energy more than activation energy. But we have not included this condition, that is the proper direction. That's why now we will rewrite as rate is equal to the formula P into ZAB into e power minus EA by RT. So this formula we will write, where P is what? P is probability factor, probability for what? For the number of collisions having proper direction. How many molecules have proper direction, that will be indicated by probability factor P. So that means rate of reaction is given as rate is equal to P into ZAB into e power minus EA by RT. This is collision theory concept. Collision theory ne bahut simple se bata diya hai, do cheeze hai. When reactants aapas mein collide hoga to product banega, but har collision mein product nahi banega. Simple baat hai, bata raha hu. Har collision mein product nahi banega. Kaun sa collision mein product banega? Ek to condition energy uske paas activation energy se zyada hona chahiye, और दूसरा कंडीशन प्रॉपर डायरेक्शन होना चाहिए. ये दोनों कंडीशंस होगा तो प्रोडक्ट बनेगा, वरना प्रोडक्ट नहीं बनेगा. तो इसके लिए हमने ये बता दिया ZAB मतलब कितने कोलिजन्स हो रहे हैं पहली बार, और उस कोलिजन में कितने के पास एनर्जी एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी से ज्यादा है और कितने के पास प्रॉपर डायरेक्शन है. ये दोनों चीज इंक्लूड करेंगे तो फिर आपको रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन मिल जाएगा. ये है हमारा कोलिजन थ्योरी. और बाद में कोलिजन थ्योरी का लिमिटेशन भी बोल सकते हैं. द लिमिटेशन वी कैन से इज दे अज्यूम्ड ऑल द रिएक्टेंट एज हार्ड स्फीयर एंड इग्नोर्ड द स्ट्रक्चरल एस्पेक्ट्स. इट मींस ईच रिएक्टेंट कैन नॉट बी हार्ड स्फीयर, दे हैविंग सम डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर, टेट्राहेड्रल स्ट्रक्चर, ट्राइगोनल बाइपिरामिडल स्ट्रक्चर, स्क्वायर प्लेनर स्ट्रक्चर. दे डिड नॉट कंसिडर द स्ट्रक्चर, दे थॉट दैट ईच रिएक्टेंट एज हार्ड स्फीयर. That is the limitation of collision theory. Fine. So understood this collision theory concept? So take the notes. Fine. Thank you. Yes.
Now what we will do is, we will solve the remaining excess question. Some excess questions were solved in the previous classes and some are remaining. So let us solve the remaining also, so that chapter will be over. Yes. So take out your textbooks also. We will solve some excess questions. So in the previous class we did some 13, 14, 16, 17, 18, 19. I have given these questions. Today I'll start from last. Question number 30. I just write the given data. You have to give me the formula and you have to solve the question. So writing the data is most important in numericals. Many of us get scared of numericals. बहुत सारे लोगों को डर लगता है न्यूमेरिकल से. क्यों डर लगता है? क्योंकि वो डेटा एनालिसिस नहीं करता. डेटा एनालिसिस करो, आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन मिल जाएगा. द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन क्वाड्रपल. क्वाड्रपल मीन फोर टाइम्स. व्हेन टेम्परेचर चेंजेस फ्रॉम 293 केल्विन टू 313 केल्विन. यानी टेम्परेचर, इनिशियल टेम्परेचर इज 293 केल्विन एंड फाइनल टेम्परेचर T2 इज 313 Kelvin. And rate constant, let us say initial rate constant is K and final rate constant K2 will be quadruple this error. It is going to be 4 times 4K. Calculate activation energy of reaction. EA is what? Assuming that temperature, it does not change with temperature. So which formula can be used here? You tell me the formula. So T1, T2, K1, K2 is there. The formula, we know that log K2 by K1 is equal to EA by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. But this formula we can use. So log K2. K2 is 4K divided by K is equal to EA by 2.303 R value, R is 8.314 into 1 by 293 minus 1 by 313. So I think you can solve this question. So KK get cancelled, log 4 is 0.6021. This one you can bring this side, into 2.303 into 8.314. LCM into 293 into 313 divide by, so subtraction is 20 is equal to EA. So you have to find the EA value. Whatever the answer it will come, it will come in the units of joule per mole, but that can be expressed in kilojoule also. So divide by 1000. Divide by 1000, then you will get kilojoule per mole. So this is the question, very very easy question. So analysis of data is most important, so don't get scared. So T1 is given to you, T2 is given to you, K1, K2 are there. We have to find EA. We just have to apply our brain. We have to recall the formula, suitable formula. Suitable formula is this. Then understood? So take note of it. Then question number 28. I will explain 29 also, but now we'll see question number 28. Question number 28. The decomposition of A into products has the value of K. It reaction has A gives products has the value of K, rate constant K is given as 4.5 into 10 power 3 second inverse at temperature 10 Celsius. You have to convert into Kelvin compulsory. 10 Celsius means 283 Kelvin. Now, and activation energy EA is 60 kilojoule per mole.
60 kilojoule per mole.
Now, at what temperature K would be? This is a K1 and K2 is given. K2 is 1.5 into 10 power 4 second inverse at what temperature? T2 is question mark.
Now you tell me the suitable formula. Which formula is suitable here?
Same formula? Same formula only we can apply.
Log K2 by K1 is equal to EA by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. K2 and K1 both are given. Log K2. K2 is 1.5 into 10 power 4 divided by 4.5 into 10 power 3 is equal to EA value. EA value is 60 divided by 2.303 into 8.314 into 1 by T1 is 283 minus 1 by T2. Yes. If you do like this, then you are wrong.
बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स ये गलती करते हैं कि यहाँ पर देखिए यूनिट इज किलो जूल. हियर दिस वैल्यू इज इन जूल, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव टू पुट इनटू 10 पावर 3. इफ यू पुट इनटू 10 पावर 3 देन ओनली यू आर राइट. सो सिंप्लीफिकेशन वर्क 15 वन्स और 15 थ्रीज आर. सो इट मींस लॉग 10 डिवाइड बाय 3 इज इक्वल टू 60,000 डिवाइड बाय 2.303 into 8.314 into 1 by 283 minus 1 by T2. So this you have to solve and you will get the value of T2. Temperature T2 is something in the units of Kelvin. So I hope you understood this one. Data is important. You should be able to write the data. So once you write the data, you will get the formula, but don't do this mistake. It is a kilojoule and this is in joule, so we have to convert that into 10 power 3. So we will get answer. Simplification is not so easy. Practice this without what? Calculator and log table. So with calculator and log table, you will not get answer. Means, in examination calculator is not allowed. So next question number 29 also will solve. Now question number 29. The time required for 10% completion of first order reaction. The time required for 10% completion of first order reaction at 290 Kelvin is equal to that required for 25% completion at 308 Kelvin. So ये सबसे बड़ी खतरनाक वाली सेंटेंस है. अगर आप ये सेंटेंस समझ जाओगे फिर बाकी ईजी है. The time required for 10% completion at 298 Kelvin is equal to the time required for 25% completion at 308 Kelvin.
So here A value is given, Arrhenius constant A is 4 into 10 power 10 second inverse. Calculate your K value at 318 Kelvin, so different temperature, and Ea. So how will we get this? See, temperature T1 is given to us, T2 is given to us. If we get K1 and K2, I can apply the formula log K2 by K1 is equal to log K2 by K1 is equal to Ea by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. This is the formula to find Ea. Here T1 and T2 are given, 298 and 308. R is known. If I get K1 and K2, my question is over. I can solve the question. So now we have to think how to get K1 and K2. If we get these two, that's over. So here they said it is a first order reaction, 10% completion. Here they said the 10% completion, 10% completion is equal to 25% completion at 308 Kelvin. So here what I'll do is case one for 10% completion. 10% completion. So according to first order reaction formula, K1 is equal to 2.303 by T log R0 by R. Is it the formula? Formula, first order. In the numerical itself it is said, first order reaction. So K1 is equal to 2.303 by, let us say, T1 log R0, let us say 100, R 10% completed. 10% completed means R value, final concentration. Final, what is left? 90 is left. 90 is left. So T1 is equal to, let it be this one. So let us do simplification. K1 is equal to 2.303 by T1 into log 10 by 9. Log 10 by 9, which is nothing but log 10, 1.000 minus 0.9590, I think. Log 9 value, I have to see. Nine five four zero. So what will come this value? 0.05. This is the equation number one. So similarly, this is for case one for 10% completion. Now case two. For which percent completion? 25% completion at 308 Kelvin. Temperature is changed. Temperature change means rate constant will change. Here we have taken K2, here we should K1, we should take here K2. If temperature is the same, then K also remains same. But here temperature changes, so rate constant changes. So here K2 is equal to 2.303 by T2 log R0 by R. So now is equal to 2.303 by T2 log 100 by, what will come? 25% completed means 75 will be left. So is equal to 2.303 by T2, it is a log 4 by 3. Log 4 means 0.6021 minus 0.4771. It is 0, 12 minus 7, 5, 11 minus 7, 4. So that's 9 minus 7, 2. Carry on. So 5 minus 4, 1, 0.1250.
0.125.
That is the equation number 2. Now answer is no. पहले हमें क्या प्रॉब्लम था, हमें के टू के वन मालूम नहीं था, अब के टू के वन मिल गए ना, बस नाउ यू कैन सॉल्व इट. सो लेट अस डू के टू बाई के वन. के टू बाई के वन इज इक्वल टू, हियर टी वन एंड टी टू आर सेम. दिस इज टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर 10% कंप्लीशन इज टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर 25% कंप्लीशन. इट मीन्स टाइम इज सेम, दोनों में टाइम सेम है. तो ये पूरा टर्म कट जाएगा, फिर बचर कौन सा है, K2 by K1 is equal to 0.125 divided by 0.045, which means 125 divided by 45. Now according to that formula, log K2 by K1 is equal to EA by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. क्या आप अप्लाई कर सकते हैं? log K2 by K1 हमारे पास है 125 divided by 45 is equal to EA तो हमें ढूंढना है upon 2.303 into 8.314 into 1 by T1 क्या है? T1 it's a 298 Kelvin minus 1 T2 308. So you will solve this and you will get answer activation energy. EA is something in the unit of joule per mole. समझ में आया? क्वेश्चन बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है, मजेदार क्वेश्चन है, क्योंकि टफ है इसलिए तो मजेदार है. टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर 10% कंप्लीशन एट 298 केल्विन इज इक्वल टू द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर 25% कंप्लीशन एट 308. पहले केस वन हम फर्स्ट ऑर्डर बोला है, इसलिए फर्स्ट ऑर्डर का फॉर्मूला अप्लाई कर रहा हूं. दोनों में टेम्परेचर अलग है, टेम्परेचर अलग है, इसलिए रेट कॉन्स्टेंट चेंज होगा के वन के टू, बट टाइम दोनों में सेम है. बोला कि भाई टाइम दोनों में इक्वल है, इसलिए ये दोनों टर्म कट जाएगा, फिर बाकी आंसर. अब क्वेश्चन कंप्लीट नहीं हुआ है, अब दूसरा कुछ पूछा है. ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट के, ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट के, कैलकुलेट के एट 318 टेम्परेचर. इस बार ये अलग टेम्परेचर है, तो इसका के कैसे आएगा? लेट अस से दिस इज अ के थ्री, ये के वन है, ये के टू है, के थ्री है, तो वो कैसे निकालेंगे बताइए. दो मेथड से उसका आंसर निकालने का. मेथड वन मैं आपको पहले बताता हूं, फिर मेथड टू जो इंटरेस्टेड स्टूडेंट्स है जो वो लोग कर सकते हैं. मेथड वन क्या है, हमारा फॉर्मूला है लॉग K is equal to log A minus EA by 2.303 RT. ये फॉर्मूला है ना अपने पास, उससे निकाल सकते हैं. K तो ढूंढना है, A दिया हुआ है क्वेश्चन में, EA अभी अभी हमने निकाल दिया है, एंड R एंड T, T is 318, that we can do. This is one way. What is another way? This is the normal way of finding the under, or the under method is this. I am taking as K3, so I can use this formula, that is log K3 by K1 is equal to EA by 2.303 R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T3. I can apply this one also, no problem. So K3 we have to find, K1 is given to us, K1 this value, K1 is not so easy because time is not there. K3 by K1, here also we can get activation energy is known, R is known, T1 is known, T3 is known. Yes, you will get that one also. So you apply any of the method, either this one or this one, you will get answer. Both of them you can apply and you will get easy answer. So there are two methods to solve this question. So this is a totally 5 marks question. Bahut bada question hai. So तो पहले यहां तक वो अब समझ गए होंगे. फिर सेकंड क्या है, सेकंड पार्ट, कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ के एट 318 केल्विन, ये पूछा है. तो इसमें दो मदद है, एक तो ये फॉर्मूला अप्लाई कर सकते हैं लॉग के या के 3 इज इक्वल टू लॉग ए माइनस ई ए बाई 2.303 आर टी. ए इज गिवन, ई ए वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, आर इज नोन एंड टी इज ऑल्सो नोन टू अस, और दिस सेकेंड मेथड कैन बी अप्लाई. सो यू ट्राई इट एंड प्रैक्टिस इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. सो इट सीम्स इजी, हाँ ये सब्स्टिट्यूट करना तो हो जाएगा, ऐसा नहीं, कैलकुलेट पर तो मालूम पड़ेगा. सो टेक द नोट्स. Fine. So we have solved 30 questions, 29, 28, 3 questions for them. Yes. Now question number. Yes. 20, 30 हो गए, 28, 29 भी हो गए. अब question number 27 देखिएगा. The rate constant for the first order decomposition of H2O2 is given by something. It means log K is given as 14.34 minus 1.25 into 10 power 4 K by T. वो जो K है ना, दैट इज कैपिटल K. कैपिटल K means Kelvin. Kelvin लिखने की जरूरत नहीं, टेम्परेचर T. ओके, सो डोंट बी कंफ्यूज. स्मॉल K इज फॉर रेट कॉन्स्टेंट एंड कैपिटल K इज फॉर टेम्परेचर. सो दिस इज वन. कैलकुलेट EA. So the aim is we have to find EA. That's a question mark. And question second thing is at what temperature will half life period be? 256 minutes. T half will be 256 minutes at temperature question mark. Initial temperature is given? No. So that is the question we have to solve. Yes, you tell me how can we solve this question? EA, first how will we get EA value? How will we get this EA first? So that's a very simple thing. You need to multiply log K2 by K1. It's not necessary always. Compare this equation with our formula log k is equal to log a minus ea by 2.303 rt. This is the same one, log k comparator. So from comparison what we will get? Ea by 2.303 rt is equal to 1.25 into 10 power 4 by T. So TT gets cancelled. So EA is equal to, activation energy EA is equal to 1.25 into 10 power 4 into 2.303 into R. R means 8.314. So you solve it, you will get something in the unit of joule per mole. It's over. EA we have got. Now, this is the question part. How to get this one, temperature T? Temperature we will get if I know the K value, isn't it? If I get rate constant K value, I can put the K value here, so I will get T. So for rate constant we can get from T half. For first order reaction, what is the formula here? T half is equal to 0.693 by K. So K is equal to 0.693 by T half, which means 0.693 by 256, but it has to be in seconds compulsory, that's why 60 seconds. क्योंकि यहाँ जो आगे का टर्म है अर्गेनियस कॉन्स्टेंट वो कंपल्सरी सेकेंड इनवर्स में होता है, इसलिए ये वाला भी सेकेंड इनवर्स में होना चाहिए, दैट्स व्हाई आई मल्टीप्लाइड विद 60. अब के वैल्यू आ गए, सब्स्टिट्यूट द के वैल्यू इन गिवन इक्वेशन, सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ के इन गिवन क्वेश्चन और गिवन इक्वेशन. So what is the given equation? Log k. Log k means 0.693 divided by 256 into 60 is equal to 14.34 minus 1.25 into power 4 divided by t. So can you solve this one? Simplification आपके हाथ में है. आपको इतना तो आना चाहिए बिकॉज यू आर एन एडवांस स्टैंडर्ड. सो हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन दैट यू मस्ट नो. सो सॉल्व इट एंड फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ टी. सो टी द यूनिट इन द इन विच यूनिट्स यू विल गेट इन द यूनिट्स ऑफ केल्विन. सी केल्विन सिंबल इज कैपिटल के, रेट कॉन्स्टेंट सिंबल इज स्मॉल के. कीप इट इन माइंड, समटाइम्स आई माइट यूज स्मॉल बिग एवरीवेयर बट कीप इट. Temperature unit Kelvin, capital K, and rate constant unit small k. That's the question number 26. It is done. So 27. Same way you can do 26, 25, 24. So what I'm doing is I'm giving you homework questions as 26, then 25, 24. 23. So these are the homework questions. You do by yourself. They are same like questions. So 22 is not necessary to solve. 22 कभी solve करना नहीं है. अभी 4-5 questions की बात है that we will solve in next class. The next class I'll explain the remaining 2-3 questions. So chapter will be over. Now practice is in your hand. We have finished 3 chapters: solid state, solutions, and chemical kinetics. And these chapters will not be revised afterwards. Keep it in mind. If you want revision, you need to again see the videos only. Otherwise, it will not be taught in this class. Small doubts will be explained, but whole topic will not be taught. That's why use this time properly and solve it.